Good day everyone. My name is Vera Budi Lestari Siotang. Today I would like to present the result of my preliminary research on transmission of traditional medicine knowledge in Sebesi Island Community, South Lampung. As we know that the local knowledge is flexible, adaptive to natural changes and transmitted informally. One of the local knowledge that is still used until now is the traditional medicine knowledge. More than 90% of traditional medicine consists of medicinal plants. And Indonesia itself has about 30,000 to 50,000 types of plants. And there are only about 7,500 can be used for medicinal plants. And one of the community still use this medicinal plants is the people of Tejang Village, Sebesi Island. With the environmental changes, rapid commercialization and economic shocks, it will be threatened the existence of local knowledge. And now people of Sebesi Island are very dependent on modern medicine. So that is why the documentation of local knowledge and understanding how the local knowledge is transmitted is important to be studied. Since the transmission and reproduction of knowledge are vital in the production of a culture of knowledge, because the knowledge generated and accumulated needs to be disseminated for the survival of society. There are some research on the transmission of knowledge which has been conducted. The first one from Dahlberg and Trigger conducted research in rural communities located adjacent to the Mukuse wetlands in KwaZulu-Natal. This research explores how knowledge is produced and transferred. The next research on transmission of knowledge is from Thornton, which discussed the transmission of knowledge. Sangoma, called traditional healers, share knowledge with one another through explicit teaching, apprenticeship, practice, and example. Laugren and Austin also discussed the role of education as a medium for transmitting Inuit knowledge. Enyu et al. Also described how the knowledge orally transferred from generation to generation through knowledgeable herbalists and elders in Ethiopia. And the last one, Macmillan explores the reach and distribution of local ecological knowledge of popular medicinal plants through a market case study in Tanga, Tanzania. Some methods which used in this research. The first one is direct observation methods in the field. The second one is in-depth interview with the informants, which consists of traditional healers, elderly people, village government official, community members, and modern medical practitioners. The third method is the collection of specimen samples, which carried out to document the types of medicinal plants for identification at Herbarium Bogoriense Research Center for Biology LIPI. And the fourth method is the literature studies in the form of journal articles, books, and website that support the research focus. So this is the brief description about the Sebesi Island. Sebesi Island is the largest island in South Lampung Regency, covering an area of 4,643 hectares. Sebesi Island is also the island closest to Mount Anak Krakatau, which was directly affected by tsunami at the end of 2018. Sebesi Island is located in Lampung Bay and is the administrative area of Tejang Village, Sebesi Island, Raja Basa District, South Lampung Regency. Sebesi Island consists of 4 dusun, namely Dusun Bangunan, Impres, Regahan Landa, and Segenom. Related with the health facilities, Sebesi Island has 1 puskesmas pembantu or pustu and 2 midwives, which serves nearly 3,000 people from Sebesi Island. Before we study about the knowledge transmission, we need to know about the perception of sickness and health for Sebesi Island community. For Sebesi Island community, a sick condition is when a person cannot work, when the body feels sore but can still carry out daily activities. The condition cannot be said to be sick. But sick is an unstable body condition, cannot do their work as usual. Conversely, a healthy condition is that the body feels good when eating. For Sebesi Island people, there are 2 causes of illness caused by humans themselves. For example, food factors that cause high cholesterol and caused by mystical things, demons. If it hurts due to human error itself, it is advisable to see a doctor. If sick due to evil spirits or demons, are treated by a healer accompanied by prayers. Knowledge transmission refers to the dissemination of knowledge from the knowing to the recipient. The process of reproduction and transmission of knowledge determines the conditions of knowledge and society. The knowledge is only known when it is transmitted and developed, reproduced by others, especially by the younger generation. Transmission can be carried out through interactions between humans and natural resources, as well as experiences themselves. The occurrence of knowledge transmission can be influenced by several factors, namely gender, economy, age, education, affinity and trust factors, social, cultural, and environmental variables. Individual factors related to gender, male or female, are the main factors in influencing the acquisition, process, and transfer of local knowledge. In Sebesi Island, the teaching of traditional medicine is carried out so that people do not depend on chemical drugs. Medical knowledge in Sebesi community is transmitted through direct teaching and through one's own experiences. Based on the interviews conducted, the majority of informants said that knowledge was acquired during childhood. One informant acquired knowledge of medicine when he was a teenager. When asked who taught this information about traditional medicine, the biggest response was that the most common knowledge transmission took place within the family, although some also mentioned that the transmission was carried out outside the family. Several informants also mentioned that the knowledge was obtained from mothers and grandmothers. In a family, mothers have an important position as the main transmitters of knowledge, which is usually taught through grandparents, then specifically taught by grandmothers. This also shows that the important role of women in the transmission of knowledge. Treatment chosen by society to cure disease related to health behavior. According to Goffman, health behavior doesn't embrace clinical improvement or physiological recovery, but includes analysis of specific behaviors that have an impact of improvement or recovery. The choice of the Sebesi people to treat disease with traditional medicine is based on the reason that plants and animals were created by God with their benefits. For that, they must seek medical knowledge. For the Sebesi community, traditional medicine is a first aid measure when suffering from illness. And there are some types of medicinal plants that most often use, such as turmeric, ginger, lemongrass, cipuan, temulawak, and others. The form of traditional medicine most often used by Sebesi people is tangos. Tangos is part of health therapy, which is a system of sweating, a kind of sauna, by using a decoction of ginger root, alang-alang root, lemongrass, which is then put in a pan. Furthermore, the sick person will be covered with a mat or cloth by stirring the pot containing the medicinal herb decoction so that the sweat will slowly come out. Tangos treatment is carried out for 20 to 30 minutes. Tangos treatment is also accompanied by prayer. According to Slagel, the three forms of transmission are one-to-one, one-to-many, and many-to-one. In one-to-one form method, there is one agent and one receiver. There may actually be two or even multiple recipients. The point is that the number of recipients per agent is very small, allowing the agent to interact directly and continuously with its recipient in turn and give him constant attention and immediate response. One-to-one transmission is a constant feature in family life. The form of knowledge transmission in the Sebesi community refers to the one-to-one transmission model. Most of knowledge medicine in the Sebesi community is obtained either from parents or from grandparents to their children or grandchildren. Another form of knowledge transmission found in Sebesi community is the transmission of knowledge through the media, namely medical books written by midwives and then studied and practiced. Other informants obtain knowledge of traditional medicine from traditional healers. According to Cavallis, Forza, and Feldman, cultural transmission takes place vertically, which flows from experts to beginners, horizontal, one-to-many, many-to-one. Based on interviews conducted with informants, the form of knowledge transmission in Sebesi community refers to the vertical, either from parents or from grandparents to their children or grandchildren. This mode of transmission is conservative. There is a little difficulty in accepting innovations at the individual level, but the innovation will spread very slowly to others in the population. Unless other modes of transmission are used together with parent-to-child transmission. The second form of transmission that occurs in Sebesi Island is the horizontal model, in which transmission occurs between two individuals regardless of their relationship. From the result of the research, we concluded that the transmission of medical knowledge is carried out by a Sebesi community to transmit and preserve knowledge. Learning of medical knowledge also encourages the introduction of plant species. Affinity and trust factor in which knowledge of medicinal plants are only transmitted, especially to the closest people who have the same social network, appear in the transmission of knowledge of Sebesi people. According to Figure 2, knowledge that is transmitted tends to be homogeneous. The types of plants used also do not show changes. The vertical mode of transmission of knowledge resulted in not much innovation in medical knowledge. The result of this study indicate that the use of traditional medicine by Sebesi Island people is still being maintained until now, even though the community's dependence on modern medicine is also very large. Due to inadequate health facilities on this island, the knowledge of traditional medicine continues to be transmitted. This study not only documents the types of medicinal plants used by Sebesi people, but also contribute to understanding how knowledge of traditional medicine is transmitted, which at the same time encourages the conservation of that knowledge. Thank you very much. From the result of the research, we concluded that the transmission of medical knowledge is carried out by a Sebesi community to transmit and preserve knowledge. Learning of medical knowledge also encourages the introduction of plant species. Affinity and trust factor in which knowledge of medicinal plants are only transmitted, especially to the closest people who have the same social network, appear in the transmission of knowledge of Sebesi people. According to Figure 2, knowledge that is transmitted tends to be homogeneous. The types of plants used also do not show changes. The vertical mode of transmission of knowledge resulted in not much innovation in medical knowledge. The result of this study indicate that the use of traditional medicine by Sebesi Island people is still being maintained until now, even though the community's dependence on modern medicine is also very large. Due to inadequate health facilities on this island, the knowledge of traditional medicine continues to be transmitted. This study not only documented types of medicinal plants used by Sebesi people, but also contribute to understanding how knowledge of traditional medicine is transmitted, which at the same time encourages the conservation of that knowledge. Thank you very much.